the Board of Trustees, faculty and students, proud parents, grandparents, siblings and friends, I want to offer congratulations to the class of 2020, the 59th graduating class of TLS. And what a year we have had. So I've been here for 24 years, standing on the TLS graduation stage, announcing award lists and calling out names. This is my first as school head. And I was really excited to share the stage with you guys, the class of 2020. I have known so many of you since you were tiny, and I've had the great privilege of watching you grow to become the fine men and women you are today. 37 of you started in preschool, 20 of you as young as 3 years old. 16 more came in lower school, and we were lucky to round out the class with the 8 that joined in middle school. The class of 2020 became complete in 7th grade when the last 3 of you joined. Our halls and your childhood will be forever woven together. Whether your first memory of TLS is going down the pole on the preschool playground or crabbing on the 7th grade trip, you formed together as a wonderful class of 61 unique and talented individuals. For just a moment, I want you to reach back to March 12th to be exact, and you'll find yourself inside the memory of our 8th grade art show. This was the last time we were all together. We were standing in the fine art hall in the middle of what may be one of the best art shows we've ever had, and the announcement came from the governor that we would move into remote learning the following week. Just a couple of weeks, he said. I never imagined we wouldn't have things back in shape by Southwest candlelight and graduation. Sitting in my office with all of you guys at home, I wrote what I must say was a good welcome to the graduation that was meant to occur on May 29th. I called one of my favorite people, Kameron Cox, to be the speaker. I knew he would be perfect. My welcome to the May 29th graduation was full of praise for you, for having your 8th grade time pause for just a few short weeks. I talked about your resilience. I talked about your good humor. But May 29th came and went, so I tore up what I was going to say. No problem, right? We were going to regroup. We were going to have a big camp out at Scarlet Gate on August 7th, followed by a traditional graduation where you would wear your white and striped ties, walk across the stage, and officially become alums of TLS. So I wrote you another welcome. We had to pivot again, canceling the camp out and the traditional graduation for this virtual moment and a drive-through diploma handoff. Some of you were still in white, some in cutoffs, others in flip-flops, but I tore that one up too. So last Wednesday night, when we were all to be together for the campfire at Scarlet Gate, I was leaving work late and I walked over to Scarlet Gate and sat where I had planned to have the camp out. The moon was super bright, and I pulled out my phone and I watched the tribute we made for the Bourbon County drive-in. For an hour, I laughed and I cried, exactly the emotions I expected to experience at the last campfire. And as I relived so many of the memories, the class of 2020, and thought about you guys, watching you stand in preschool wearing Fear the Acorn shirts, getting super competitive with Minute to Win It, building candy houses with sugar cubes, enjoying carnival, and then later becoming the host of carnival, going on trips, and playing in the snow together. In many ways, right now, I know COVID-19 is what stands out for you. The class of 2020 is not to be defined by the last 3 months. However, these last few months have allowed you to illustrate so beautifully who you are as a class and who you are as individuals. Your humor and good nature, your optimistic outlook, your ability to roll with the punches, to be disappointed but show up the next day with a smile on your face may not have been so readily seen in a normal year. This is who you are, the class of 2020. You are everything a graduate of TLS should be. I'm pretty sure, too, that you're going to become a pretty famous class. You'll be the class that started the last car line, a tribute night at a drive-in. I mean, who else gets to walk down memory lane at a 1950-style drive-in? And so many other traditions that I'm pretty sure are going to live on with your name on it. Even your class picture will hang in the hall, uniquely different than other years representing this time and place. You have helped us all reinvent special moments in the eighth grade, and that class of 2020 is your gift to the Lexington School. Soon we'll be able to gather again in groups larger than 10, and at that time we will all be together. But until that, I want you to remember how proud I am of you, how much I've enjoyed getting to know you as individuals, and how much I've enjoyed you as a class. This next year may be a little odd too. Please take your good humor, your good nature, your optimistic outlook, and your ability to roll with the punches and bring it to your high school, whether you're there in person or virtually. Influence your high school like you have influenced the Lexington School. Make us TLS proud.
I'm Jeff Truitt, Chairman of the Board of Trustees at the Lexington School. And like you, I'm an alumnus of TLS as well, graduating with the class of 1985. The Board of Trustees has been blown away with how your class has conducted themselves at the end of a very difficult eighth grade year. While you're getting ready to join a new school soon, just remember, your TLS relationship never really ends. As your teachers referenced in their send-off video to you, TLS will always be here for you. The Board of Trustees wants to congratulate you on this big accomplishment and also the way that you conducted yourself with a positive attitude and grace. We are very excited to hear all the new adventures that you're going to be taking on in the next 2 years, so please keep this in mind. Congratulations.
Permanent Heads List is a real achievement. The students whose names you see listed here were on high honors each semester of their time in the middle school and earned no grade below a commendable in specials classes. Congratulations, Colts.
Among many other firsts for the class of 2020, you guys have the honor of listening to Lexington School's first virtual commencement speaker. As you can imagine, since we started graduation in 1963, each commencement speaker has been in person, behind the podium, in front of a live audience. Today, Kameron Cox, the class of 2006, speaks to us from New York City. He brings the goodness of this new normal while emphasizing the balance of lifetime truths of TLS. From his Midtown Manhattan law office, Kameron took a moment recently to talk TLS to us, describing his path from Lane Allen Road to the New York Times building on 8th Avenue. He said, "I remember being exactly where these eighth graders are now. My graduation morning is clear as a bell still to me. We were outside on the hill. It was hot as all get out, and Miss Bonzo was crying." Tate's Creek High School was next for Kameron, where he earned an international baccalaureate diploma. He was also a national achievement finalist, which gave him a full ride at Auburn University. The lifelong importance of TLS friendships was another strong theme for Kameron. He said, "Rashad Bennett, class of 2008, is still my best friend. We've been in touch basically every day since fifth grade, and since he was in fifth grade and I was in third grade. We have a running text and it's meaningful to both of us." Again, connecting with TLS, Kameron declared, "Vanderbilt Law School was the first time I had a class that I thought was harder than Bonzo's English class. It did not happen until that law school class." Post-law, Kameron headed to the legal world of the Big Apple, where his focus is security work at Covington and Burling. He recently learned of another TLS connection, Philip Howard, class of 1963, the first graduating class of TLS, who is senior counsel at his firm. Kameron explained, "I knew he was from Kentucky, but I had no idea he went to TLS. Philip himself, who was the TLS commencement speaker in 1996, was delighted to hear this connection as well. From outside New York City, in quarantine, Philip said, "What a small world it is. Kameron Cox and I graduated from TLS 40 years apart, and we end up in the same law firm in New York City. Of course, that makes sense to me. TLS is one of the greatest schools in the country, and Covington and Burling is one of the leading law firms. So naturally, they would end together." Kameron, thank you for being with us today as we celebrate this virtual moment with roots deep in TLS history.
Hello from New York City, and congratulations to the class of 2020. Everyone's really excited for you guys. Admittedly, the introduction makes me sound a lot more impressive than I really am. I've never been anything more than a TLS boy at heart, and I will be the first one to tell you that. As I said, I'm an attorney up in New York at a large law firm based out of DC. And I'm just another person who kind of works there for now, but trust me, there are some really impressive people there that you've probably heard of who do really cool things throughout their career. And who knows really where my story will end. Before that, I was down in Nashville at Vanderbilt Law School, where I served as the Chief Justice of the Moot Court Board. Before that, I was at Auburn, where I graduated magna cum laude and held a number of positions on campus and various student leadership. And before that, it was Tate's Creek's IB program, which helped me to earn a full ride down at Auburn. But before all of that, before any of that stuff that I just mentioned, I sat right where you do. And I mean right there, because remember, I've never been anything but a TLS boy. I mean, I guess I don't mean right there, because there was no COVID when I graduated, but I remember vividly sitting in the exact same position that you do today. I was optimistically nervous about going to a new place, pessimistically nervous about disappointing my parents, and honestly, a little bit excited about the transition. And all of this came after, you know, memorizing a million bones from Miss Lounsbury, just crushing so many Crispitos all the time, sitting on the bench for the basketball team, being like, oh, why can't I play? It's because you're not very good, Cam. And then just getting kicked out of PE constantly by Mr. Parlante, who I'm sure is somewhere also laughing because he knows that's true. You know, it's kind of like, Cam, how do you get kicked out of PE class? That's the one time you're allowed to be loud. But anyway, they say a good speech is about the three B's. Be funny, be brief, and be gone. And I'm trying to imagine your smiling faces, so hopefully I've handled the first one, and if not, just let me imagine that I'm more entertaining than I am. We'll move on to the second. Now, I'm still a TLS boy at heart, but admittedly, I guess I've kind of made a few moves since then. But today is about you, your new beginning. And Miss McCarthy told me to tell you what I know about life. So take a second. And I want you, each of you, seriously, just work with me here, to envision your highest professional goals. Really picture your dreams and where you want to be when you get to be your parents' age or your grandparents' age or my age, you know, just when you're a little older. What are you doing? Where are you living? Who are you impacting? And who are you helping? And for the rest of my time with you, I want you to just hold on to that picture. Just walk with me for a second and kind of indulge me. You just graduated from the best K-8 institution in this country, from sea to shining sea. I don't care that it was ranked number 2 by somebody somewhere at one time, whatever. What I'm telling you here today is that it's number 1. I've met people now who went to all the Ivies and MITs and Stanfords and Georgia Tech and all that, but I've never met anyone with a stronger elementary and middle school experience than those who were a TLS dream. Honestly, because of our country's private school network, this is probably the best K-8 in the world, like the whole world. So, you know, I said sea to shining sea, make that all 7 C's, okay? Like it's a very, very good school, and I don't know that you quite appreciate it just yet. And I'll tell you something that I didn't appreciate when I was in your shoes. At this exact moment, nobody is more prepared or more likely to reach those goals that you have than you are. Opportunity is, of course, a huge part of getting to where you want to be. And you had that because you started at TLS. So at this point, the only thing separating you from where you are right now and where you want to be in 10 or 20 or 30 years are hard work and time. Trust me, I sit here with wrinkles behind these glasses under my eyes. The time part is not really optional. But hard work is. You still have that picture of your goals in your head, right? Well, I want to challenge each of you to commit to that. Remember that picture and decide that your dreams are worth it. Now, here's what I'm not supposed to tell you. It's hard. Like, it's going to be very hard to reach those dreams. And it's hard for 2 reasons. First, there's a pressure to perform when the moment is there. There are going to be critical times in your development that will have a major impact on your future. In the coming years, some of you will defend dissertations, you will sit for the MCAT, You will interview with congresswomen, and some will even ask investors for seed money. You may know nervous, but I will just tell you from experience, you don't know nervous like New York bar exam nervous, right? But in those moments, remember your foundation. You're an alum of the Lexington School. If you've done your eighth grade talk, or you've crammed for Miss Cowling's final, or you shot a fourth quarter free throw against Sayre, then you know how to perform under pressure. Hold on to those experiences. And when the time comes where it gets a little bit nerve-wracking, you'll be fine. The second thing is the competition is fierce. In this moment, you are in the lead, just like I said. But as soon as you step out of here, there are going to be kids from all over the country gunning for your spot at your dreams. And I'll be frank, because you may not know this yet, some of those kids competing with you, they're going to be smarter than you. They're going to pay for more expensive SAT tutors than you. They may even go to more celebrated high schools than you. And they're going to probably have access to fancier extracurricular activities than you. And I'll be really blunt here, guys. Their parents have more money than yours. But they're no better than you. But if you loaf around or you party too much, you become complacent with this lead that you've got, you're going to lose your opportunity. But when it comes to competing, remember your foundation. You're an alum of the Lexington School. If you can remember enough to pass Bonzo's grammar test, then you've got the discipline. And if you can successfully handle lacrosse practice the night before Lounsbury's cell exam, I promise that you understand time management. And if you could successfully plan Carnival and Little Kentucky Derby, then you understand that proper preparation is what promotes performance. Just apply what you've learned here, and you're going to get there. You're going to be just fine. So when the path gets challenging to reach that dream, you remember who you are. Remember your foundation. You're an alum of the Lexington School. Your dreams are worth fighting for, and you can and you will reach those goals despite the competition and despite the challenges. Because if today you decide that you're going to apply yourself and you're going to do it, then you will. So what does our alma mater say? A proud tradition grows, right? You're an alum now. Grow that tradition. Stand on the foundation and build on the great experience you've already had. You owe it to your parents, you owe it to your teachers, but most of all, you owe it to yourselves. I speak for the rest of the alumni when I say that we're here to help you. Anyone who ever learned on Lane Allen is going to be a friend of yours. So feel free to reach out to any of us with any questions or for guidance, because we're here to serve you. And with that, I'll leave you with just two parting thoughts. First, you have a bright future. So when you reach those goals, reach back and help out. And second, when you grow up, there's still going to be a strict dress code every day. So you just kind of have to get used to that. It's the worst. No one will ever get TLS to change that. Thanks again, and congratulations to the class of 2020. I'll see you guys, and good luck. Thank you.
Graduation is always one of those bittersweet moments for me. At one point, kids are going on and doing what they should, and I'm super proud of them. Another, a part of our family is moving away, and that actually makes me sad. So today is about the class of 2020, but we would be remiss on not recognizing the class of 2020's families, the parents of the class of 2020. The reason these kids are where they are is because of you and all that you've put in your years over the Lexington School to have them here, to support them while they're here, to support us as a school. So thank you to the parents of class of 2020. In a way, you're graduating too. You're moving on, but this is always your home, just like for our kids. And we hope that you will find yourself turning back into 1050 Lane Allen Road sooner rather than later. Congratulations to everybody.